It's December 2013, and I'm laying in bed, not wanting to be awake, not wanting to go anywhere, do anything, talk to anyone. And I'm feeling hopeless, unmotivated, feeling without purpose, and asking the universe or whatever divine entity there is, if this can just be over already. Can I just go? I'm done. Can I just throw in the towel? I don't want to be here anymore. And I eventually muster up the strength to get to work, interact with my friends and family, hiding behind this smile everyone knew so well. My little secret, or big secret, I was depressed, and no one had any idea. Not even my mom, who lived in the room next door. No one had any idea. And for me, depression was this self-sabotaging, lack of self-worth, lack of self-confidence, and lack of self-esteem. This self-hatred. I hated myself, and I felt like I just couldn't be here anymore. I didn't want to do life anymore. So I would numb the pain with alcohol, being with my friends, doing something that was a temporary fix for happiness. And most of all, I would just want to go to sleep. I would want to sleep because dream world was way better than being awake. So I lay there and I wonder, how did I get to this point? I was this charismatic child who loved life, who wanted to interact with everyone and be happy all the time and dancing and playing. And how did I get to this point in my 20s where I'm so depressed I don't want to be here anymore? How did I fall into this dark black hole, just like hiding? And I laid there picturing what this dark hole really looked like, and being able to look up and barely seeing the light, and wondering, how am I ever going to climb out of here? So December 4th, 2013, I sat down and wrote out a little blog about this hole I was going to climb out of, and I'm just going to read a little bit of it for you here. Finally, with an inkling of hope and faith in myself, I decide to make the climb. I'm not as strong as I used to be, but I still want to believe anything is possible if you just have faith in yourself. Obviously, climbing, especially without a harness, can only mean that you have a chance of falling again. Attitude can also affect this climb, because if you are so used to falling, you think that falling is normal, and you may keep falling over and over again. So what needs to change? Climbing on the other side of the hole? Maybe. Sometimes taking on a climb and a different approach can really be eye-opening. However, it all really comes back to attitude and what you tell yourself. Thoughts have that powerful way of dictating exactly what you'll manifest. Maybe everyone should fall in a hole at least once in their lives to understand how good life really is if you allow yourself the chance to make it better. If you find the inner strength and outer strength from the amount of times you pick yourself up and climb again, then most likely you can take on anything when it comes your way moving forward. What is great is after starting to climb and falling a few times, you realize you climb higher and higher each time because you've learned how to do it better at every attempt. I've lost count of the amount of times I've fallen after the initial start of the climb. However, I feel like I'm above halfway now and the light is starting to look real pretty. I stand before you guys today to ignite in you the fact that you can choose. You can choose to wallow in this hole, in this darkness, or you can choose to climb out, to choose to have courage and fortitude every single day to be happy, to choose love. Yes, we say there's so many horrible things going on in this world, and we get consumed by it. But I offer you the chance to choose love every single day. Choose. You are the example. It starts with you. So if you choose love, If you choose to love the people around you and be the example, then we allow ourselves to get away from the horrible things that are happening and focus on what's good in front of us. I'm also going to share with you a formula. E plus R equals O. E represents the experiences and events that are thrown at you. R represents the reactions and responses. O is outcome. We all have our events and experiences that throw us off or make us laugh or anything, and what we can control is the R portion of the formula, your reactions and your responses. That's where you get to choose. So you can react poorly, and something can go horribly wrong, and that's the outcome, but it all comes back to you. So I'm going to read the very conclusion of my blog. This hole is getting really old, and I'm ready to reach the top. Attitude is what will guide me, my faith in myself, and what I have the potential to achieve. And as a super Lost fan, I have to throw in a John Locke quote, "Don't tell me what I can't do.